Good morning, everyone. Bonjour à tous. Lundi, j'ai eu la chance de rencontrer des gens incroyables aux premières lignes de la campagne de vaccination de masse à Montréal. Que ce soit des pharmaciens qui conservaient les doses à la bonne température ou les infirmières qui administraient les vaccins, c'était remarquable de voir tout le monde travailler en équipe. L'organisation au centre de vaccination était impressionnante et ensemble, on va faire en sorte que le plus de gens possible soit protégé le plus rapidement possible. Vaccines are the path out of this pandemic. And that's why securing doses and getting them to the front lines is my number one priority. Yesterday, you may have heard that the White House is talking about sending Canada 1.5 million doses of AstraZeneca. We're finalizing an agreement with this, on this with the American administration as we speak. This is something that Minister Anand and I have raised a number of times with the President and his team. We're working closely and very well with the Biden administration on many fronts, including vaccines. I want to thank President Biden for his collaboration. Canada and the U.S. are each other's closest friends and most important allies. And I know we'll continue to continue working to keep Canadians and Americans safe, beat this virus, and rebuild strong, thriving economies together. Tout vaccin approuvé au Canada est sécuritaire et vous pouvez le recevoir en toute confiance. C'est vrai pour celui d'AstraZeneca, de Pfizer, de Moderna et de Janssen. Hier, Santé Canada a participé à une réunion de l'Agence européenne des médicaments durant laquelle il a été confirmé que le vaccin d'AstraZeneca est sûr et efficace. Le meilleur vaccin pour vous, c'est le premier qui vous est offert. Ces vaccins vont vous aider à rester en sécurité et protéger ceux que vous aimez. We've already delivered over 4.7 million vaccine doses to the provinces and territories. And this week, we got more good news about shipments from Pfizer. Last Friday, I said that we would have 1 million new Pfizer doses every 7 days between March 22nd and early May. Well, yesterday, we confirmed that we will continue to receive over 1 million doses a week through to the end of May. Everyone who wants to will be fully vaccinated by the end of September, as we've been saying for months. Yesterday, we also approved the deployment of the Canadian Armed Forces to northern Manitoba in order to help roll out vaccines in First Nations communities that are otherwise hard to reach. This is about working in partnership with First Nations on their efforts to get as many people vaccinated as soon as possible. The Armed Forces are currently doing detailed planning of the deployment for up to 23 communities in northern Manitoba. Again, I want to thank all of our members of the Armed Forces who step up time and time again to keep Canadians safe. Pour mettre fin à la pandémie, pour rebâtir suite à la crise économique mondiale, on doit tous travailler ensemble. Hier, j'ai parlé avec la directrice générale du Fonds monétaire international, Kristalina Georgieva, à propos de la relance économique à l'échelle mondiale. Il faut rebâtir et il faut le faire d'une façon qui bénéficie à tous, y compris et surtout les plus vulnérables. La directrice générale Georgieva et moi avons discuté du rapport annuel du FMI qui souligne les effets positifs et concrets de nos actions pour soutenir les Canadiens à travers cette crise. Mercredi, j'ai aussi parlé avec le premier ministre de l'Italie, Mario Draghi. Nos deux pays sont des partenaires de longue date liés par nos populations et nos valeurs. Le Canada accueille avec enthousiasme le leadership de l'Italie dans le cadre de sa présidence du G20 de cette année. Le premier ministre et moi avons, entre autres, discuté des mesures visant à permettre aux familles et aux entreprises de passer à travers ces moments difficiles. Et bien entendu, on a également parlé de l'importance de la vaccination en vue d'assurer la sécurité des Canadiens, des Italiens et des gens partout dans le monde. Les vaccins et les programmes comme la prestation canadienne de la relance économique aident les gens à rester en santé et en sécurité. Mais il faut aussi qu'ils aient accès à un chez-soi sûr et abordable. La dernière année nous a rappelé à quel point c'est important d'avoir un toit au-dessus de sa tête. mais pour beaucoup trop de gens, c'est pas quelque chose qu'ils peuvent tenir pour acquis. Since 2015, we've made historic investments in housing from coast to coast to coast. And last year, when the pandemic hit hard, we knew that we had to do even more and faster. And that's why we invested $1 billion in the new Rapid Housing Initiative to quickly create homes right across the country. At the time, this investment was for 3,000 units. Well, earlier today, Minister Hussein had some great news to share. We're not just going to meet our targets, we're going to exceed it. The Rapid Housing Initiative will now mean over 4,700 more homes, almost 40% of which will be for Indigenous people. This is about more than just a roof over someone's head. It's about hope. It's about a brighter future. Just take what an affordable home has meant for a single parent like Sabrina from Peterborough. Thanks to the local Habitat for Humanity condo development and the funding they received from the federal government, she's able to raise her kids in the good, safe place they deserve. Rebâtir après la pandémie, c'est de faire en sorte que tout le monde au Canada dispose des outils nécessaires pour réussir. Notre plan va aider plus de familles à acheter une maison. Il va contribuer à créer 1 million d'emplois pour les travailleurs de tous les âges. Et notre plan va permettre à l'ensemble des Canadiens de faire un retour en force vers un avenir meilleur et plus solide. Finally, let me say a few words about Michael Spavor and Michael Kovrig. Michael Spavor's hearing took place earlier today. The court has not yet pronounced a verdict. Michael Kovrig's hearing is scheduled for Monday. Let me be very clear. Their arbitrary detention is completely unacceptable, as is the lack of transparency around these court proceedings. Our top priority remains securing their release. We will continue to work tirelessly to bring them home as soon as possible. I want to thank our many, many international partners, friends, and allies for their solidarity and support. Going forward, we will continue to be in close contact with the families during this difficult time. To their loved ones, know that today and every day, Canadians are with you and thinking of both Michaels. Merci beaucoup.